Welcome you all for the lecture on significance of dimensionless numbers in turbo machines. Dimensionless parameter and their physical significance in turbo machines. A large number of variables are involved in describing the performance characteristics of the turbo machines. That means in a turbo machine, the performance is evaluated by taking the more number of variables. It consists of head of the water, then discharge, then speed of the rotor, diameter of the rotor, viscosity of the fluid. That means the so many variables are influenced on the performance of a turbo machines. So because of large number of variables, the more number of experiments have to be conducted in a performance test. So this involves the more time is required to conduct the more number of the performance test. The cost of the design and experimentation will also more. So in order to reduce this performance test time, so as well as to reduce the cost of the design, so these number of variables are grouped into non-dimensional quantities which are less in number than the variable involves. So then in design or experimentation, these dimensional quantities are varied instead of large number of parameters forming these groups. So this is significance of dimensionless numbers in a turbo machines. That means the small expressions are formed by grouping of these more number of variables, and so this method reduces the duration or time required to conduct the performance test, as well as it will reduce the cost of the design as well as experimentation. Application of dimension analysis to a general fluid flow problems. So in the performance of the turbo machine depends on the following variables. So that is discharge denoted by Q, the speed of the rotor N, size of the rotor or size of the rotor diameter is D, energy per unit mass flow given by GH, power P, density of the fluid rho, and dynamic viscosity of the fluid given by mu. So these are the some parameters that will influence the performance of the turbo machine. So now this many variables are formed into a small number of expressions by using Buckingham Pi theorem. So in a dimensionless parameter, there are two methods are commonly used. That is, first one is Rayleigh's method, another one is Buckingham Pi theorem. In case the more number of variables are influenced on a performance of any machines, so at that time the Buckingham Pi theorem is preferred. So here in this analysis, the functional relationship is given by the power output from the turbine is a function of discharge, speed, diameter, then energy, and density and dynamic viscosity of the fluid. So we can write this in general. General relationship is the function of Q, N, D, GH, P, rho and mu is equals to constant. So in this problem, so there are total 7 variables influence the performance of the turbo machine. So for that reason, the number of variables are N is equals to 7. The number of fundamental variables M is equals to 3, that is MLT. The number of phi terms is calculated by using the expression or relation N minus M, that is 7 minus 3 is equals to 4. So now we are getting the 4 different phi terms. So in order to solve this expression by using this Buckingham Pi theorem, we need to select repeating variables from three different groups. The one from the geometric property, one from the fluid property, another one from the flow property. So according to that, the three variables are density, speed and diameter of the rotor. After solving this expression by using the Buckingham Pi theorem, then finally we are getting the four different pi terms, that is phi 1, phi 2, phi 3 and phi 4. So according to that, the phi 1 is equals to given by Q by ND cube, phi 2 is equals to GH by N square D square, phi 3 term, that is P by rho N cube D power 5, and fourth phi term is mu by rho n d square. So in this numerical, there are three fundamental dimensions, then four phi terms you are getting, the repeating variables taken as rho n d, and remaining terms on these seven variables are discharge, then energy head, then power, then viscosity of the fluid. So these are all four different phi terms. What are the significance of these phi terms? The first one, the first phi term is called as capacity coefficient or flow coefficient or specific capacity and speed ratio. The term phi 1 is equals to Q by ND cube is the capacity coefficient or flow coefficient or specific capacity, so which signifies volume flow rate of fluid through a turbo machine of unit diameter of runner operating at unit speed. The specific capacity is constant for similar rotors, that means the similar motor and prototype. Hence, for a fan or pump of certain diameter running at various speeds, so here discharge is directly proportional to speed. If diameter is taken as constant for two machines, so now at that time the discharge is directly proportional to speed, and this is the first of fan law. So according to this, phi 1 is equals to Q by ND cube. So Q is equals to discharge. The discharge is measured in terms of meter cube per second. So now discharge is equals to area into velocity. Discharge is given by area into velocity. So here area is taken as D square, and velocity V is equals to velocity of the fluid divided by ND cube. So now after simplifying these expressions, the D square at numerator and D cube at denominator, the D square get cancels. The final you are getting the expression V by ND cube. So we can also write this expression as V by U, because U is equals to U is equals to, it is taken as pi d n divided by 60. See here, pi d n by 60. Pi by 60 is constant. Here pi by 60 is constant. That means u is directly proportional to, u is equals to d n or n d. For that is just taken as, after simplifying this one, the remaining term, this is n d. Here n d is here, so instead of n d, we can written as here what, v by u. So then pi is equals to what? The pi is equals to, that is equals to u by v. So here it is v by u. For that reason it is taken as 1 by 5. So where phi is called as speed ratio, that is equals to u by v. So here u is equals to tangential velocity of the runner. U is equals to tangential velocity of the runner, and v is equals to tangential jet velocity of the fluid. For that reason, the phi, the speed ratio, is a ratio. Speed ratio is the ratio of tangential velocity of the runner to the tangential jet velocity of the fluid. The second pi term, that is the head coefficient, the term pi 2 is equals to gh by n square d square, is called head coefficient or specific head. The pi 2 is equals to gh by n square d square. So here gh, then can write this expression as gh by u square, because u is equals to nd. Here n square and d square is there. For that reason we can write this nd square, n square and d square as u square, or in terms of head in dimensionless form, the pi 2 is equals to, the g is taken to denominator at the attempt, h to the ratio of u square by g. So it represents the ratio of kinetic energy of the fluid, that is v is always directly proportional to square root of h under head to the kinetic energy of the fluid running at the tangential speed of the rotor. The head coefficient is constant for similar impellers. Once again, for a machine of given impeller diameter, head varies directly as the square of the tangential speed of the rotor or impeller. So in this expression, see, the h is directly proportional to square root of the tangential velocity of the rotor. The third pi term, that is a power coefficient or specific power, that is pi 3, is given by p by rho n power 3 d power 5, that is called as power coefficient or specific power. So it represents the relationship between the power, the density of the fluid, the speed and diameter of the wheel. For a given machine, the power is directly proportional to the cube of the speed of the runner or rotor. So this is called as what, the third fan law. Next, coming to the specific speed of the turbine. The specific speed is a dimensionless term and is a parameter of greatest importance in incompressible flow machines, that is the density of the fluid remains constant while it is flowing through the section 1 to the section 2. The specific speed is only the parameter that does not contain the linear dimension of the runner. So this is one advantage, it does not consist of any linear dimensions of the turbo machine or the runner. Hence, while operating under the same conditions of flow and air, all geometrically similar machines have the same specific speed irrespective of their sizes. The specific speed can be expressed in terms of discharge Q for power absorbing machine or power P for power generating machines. As so for generally the output from the power absorbing turbo machine is what? Discharge. For that is commonly taken as a discharge. The specific speed is expressed in terms of discharge for power absorbing machine. In case of turbines, it will produce power. That means you are getting the power is produced by the turbines. That is the power generating turbo machines. The output is power. For that reason, for specific speed is expressed in terms of power. Now, specific speed of a pump. The equation of specific speed for a pump can be obtained by the manipulating flow coefficient and air coefficient. Then, what cancel of the linear dimensions of the rotor or impeller. So, according to this, is denoted by the 5 by 5 term. So, that is the manipulating of what? Of flow coefficient, that is given by pi 1 term, and head coefficient, that is given by pi 2 terms. So now manipulating these two terms, or head coefficient to, flow coefficient to head coefficient. So now flow coefficient is given by Q by ND cube. Q by ND cube. Now take the power of half. Then pi 2 term is head coefficient. So that is given by GH by U square. By taking that into numerator at that time, so U square is given by D square N square, then GH at denominator, and the power is taken as 3 by 4. Then simplifying this expression, here, so here this linear dimension of the turbo machine is get cancelled, the diameter is get cancelled here. In numerator you are getting only two variables, that is speed of the rotor and discharge power of half, and the denominator is GH power of 3 by 4, so that is equals to rho. So now this specific speed of the pump, is expressed in terms of discharge. So that is what Q here, this is a discharge Q. So the specific speed of the pump is given by N into Q power of half, and G is constant here, that is neglected. Now finally we are getting H power 3 by 4. So now definition of the specific speed of the pump is like that. So this is a, it is expressed or defined as a speed of geometrically similar machines discharging 1 meter cube per second of water under a head of 1 meter. Here you are finding what is the, we are calculating what is the speed of the geometrically similar machines. So that is discharging same quantity or volume flow rate of fluid under the head of 1 meter. So that is given by specific speed of the pump. So next, specific speed of a turbine. The specific speed for a turbine can be obtained with the help of head coefficient and power coefficient terms. You can write that expressions 5, 6, that is specific speed of the turbine is equals to manipulating the two pi terms, that is pi 3 and pi 2. Pi 3 is equals to power coefficient here, and pi 2 is equals to head coefficient. The power is taken as half and 5 by 4 here. So pi 3 is equals to p by rho n power 3 and d power 3, and power of half is here. Then pi 2 is equals to head coefficient. Head coefficient is equals to g h by u square. And after simplifying this expression here, then now finally we are getting n into p power half to the rho power half into g h power of 5 by 4. It is taken as 5, 6 terms. It is a dimensionless specific speed, and here the density as well as the g are the two constant values. For that reason, it is dropped up as a constant, and finally we are getting the specific speed expression becomes: the specific speed of the turbine is given by n into p power half and to the h power 5 by 4. So now definition for the specific speed of the turbine is defined as: the speed of geometrically similar machines which produce 1 kilowatt of power under a head of 1 meter. That means, say there are geometrically similar machines here, and what is the speed of that geometrically similar machines? That two machines will produce the same unit power under a head of 1 meter. Next, what are the importance of this specific speed? It is very important parameter to select a particular type of machines and for its designing aspects, because of many machines processes maximum efficiency means it has high specific speed value. That means the efficiency of any machine is directly proportional to the specific speed value of the machine. If you consider the centrifugal pump, so here the larger rotor diameter implies as high speed. See this figure. So this is a large diameter, the centrifugal pump having the larger diameter. So then, but here the discharge is minimum. The discharge is minimum. That means the specific speed of that centrifugal pump is low. But in case of axial flow type of the pump, so here rotor diameter is minimum and more discharge is possible. Then more discharge is possible in this direction, that is axial flow directions, when compared to here in this larger diameter of impeller. Here the specific speed of the pump is maximum. Next, consider the variation of efficiency with the specific speed for various sizes of the pumps. That means you can, from this chart, we can observe that the propeller type of the turbine pump, that is axial flow type, possesses best efficiency compared to the centrifugal pump. So here this is centrifugal pump having a larger diameter. Here discharge is minimum, but the specific speed is also minimum. But consider this propeller type of the pumps here, it is axial flow type of the pumps. The more discharge is possible with the minimum diameter of the rotor, in turn the specific speed is maximum. Importance of specific speed. A variation of efficiency with the specific speed for various types of compressor. So in rotary or positive displacement machine, the specific speed is minimum, that varies from the 12 to 40 rpm. But in case of centrifugal pump, that varies from the 55 to 150 or 160 rpm. But in case of axial, we can obtain achieve more efficiency here. Now, importance of the specific speed in terms of, in case of turbines. So consider hydraulic turbine, namely Pelton wheel turbine, Francis turbine and axial flow type of the propeller or Kaplan turbine, whose efficiency variation with the specific speed as shown in figure. The Pelton wheel is provided or operated under a head of high head and low discharge turbines. That means here the fluid is exited at high velocity from the jet to the blades of the impeller. So hence here the specific speed range for good efficiency is low. For Francis turbine, it is a mixed flow type of the turbine. So it has a wide range of specific speed because it works at moderate speed as well as medium discharge. So coming to the Kaplan or the propeller turbine, it employs very high flow rate with low heads, hence its specific speed also varies for the larger extent. So this is information related to significance of the dimensionless number and relationship of specific speed of the turbine and specific speed of the pumps and its efficiency with respect to specific speed as well as the different parameters of the turbo machines. Thank you.